going to discuss about the example problems. Body of mass 5 kg. A body of mass 5 kg. So let me write the given terms. A body of mass 5 kg. So what we have given? Mass is how much? 5 kg is taken. A body of mass 5 kg is taken from a height 5 meter. So I choose the number 5 meter. 5 by the 3 is its potential energy. So what we should find out? The potential energy, that's the word, increase in potential energy. And we have also given the value of g, that is acceleration due to gravity, that is 10 m/s². So assume that this chalkpiece box is the mass of 5 kg. It is lifted up to 5 meter. So they are asking what is the increasing potential energy, that we have to find it out. And the g value they have given, because the acceleration due to gravity, that is g, is 10 m/s². Mass is given and the height is given. So we know the formula: gravitational potential energy, sorry, increase in potential energy mg equals h2 minus h1. So here they have given only one h. From a height 5 meter to 10 meter. So it will be at 5 meter. So I'm not written here h1 will be 5 meter and h2 is equals to 10 meter. Sorry, this is here. A body of mass 5 kg was lifted when the height is 5 meter. So the actual height is 5 meter and the body is lifted from 5 meter to 10 meter, and they are asking to find the increase in potential energy. So we know the formula: mg equals mg into h2 minus h1. So what is the value of m? 5 g, 10. H2 is what? 10 minus 5. 5 into 10 into 5. So 5 into 50. 55 is a 250. So what? The assignment of potential energy. Energy, that is joule. Next problem. A body of mass 1 kg. Here the mass is 1 kg. Falls from a height 5 meter. How much energy does it possess at any instance? So they are asking how much energy possess at any instance. So which energy should consider here? That is potential energy. Why? Because here a body of mass 1 kg is falling from a height of 5 meter. So the given terms, so the body is attracted towards the earth. So which formula we should use here? U is equal to mgh. So if our potential energy equals mgh. So here g value is given as 9.8 m/s². If you are not given the g value in the sense, consider it as a 9.8 only. If they are given, in the previous four problems, they have given g value as 10 m/s², but here it is given as 9.8 m/s². So here they are asking how much energy does it possess at any instant. So the energy possessed by the body at any instant. So substitute the value. 9 joule. That is initial potential energy of the body. And NH means initial potential energy of the body. So here they have not given two highs. They have given only one high. So a body of mass 1 kg falling from a high 5 meter. And they have not given the where it the final height they have not given. How much energy does it possess? 500 liter of water. 500 liter of water is raised from the first floor of a house at height 4 meter to its third floor at a height 12 meter. State whether the potential energy of water will increase or decrease. Find the decrease or increase in potential energy of water. Take G, the value of G, that is like 10 meter, 10 newton per kg, and density of 1 kg liter, density of water equals 1 kg per liter. Don't get confused here. If they have to consider mass as a volume, volume is equals to 500 liter. So like what we should find out? Mass of water we should find out. They have given the volume, that is equals to volume into density. So you should be 500. And what is density? So what you will be getting? Since H2 is greater than H1, potential energy of water also increases. This is increases symbol. Since H2 is greater than H1, potential energy of water also increases. The formula is mg into H2 minus H1. This will be the formula. So what is m? 500 and g is 9.8. So I am next. 12 minus 4, that is H2 and H1. So what you are getting? 500 into 9.8. So 500 into 80. So what you are getting? 5 is 40 into 1, 2, 3 zeros. 10 power of 3 and again 4 into 10 power of 4 joule. If next problem, fourth one, a block of mass 30 kg. A block of mass 30 kg is pulled up a slope as shown in the figure. Let me draw the diagram. A figure. First thing is, we should calculate the mass 30 kg and displacement, that is 300 meter, sorry, 3 meter, and force applied is 300. So first thing is, we should find out the work done by the force in moving the block from A to B. So we should find the work done in moving the block from A to B. We know the formula. Work done is equal to the product of force and displacement in direction of the force. So we should find out the work done in moving a block from initial position to final position from A to B. not given here. So F equals mg h, force of gravity. That is, we don't know height, no? That is force of gravity equals mg into h. We don't know the h. So that is cross multiply F divided by g. H is equal to 200 divided by 30 into 10. 1010 will be cancelled over here. And again, 1010 will be cancelled here. They are left over by 2 divided by 3. So, when you divide it, you get the answer as 1.5 meter. So, the potential energy formula is m into g into earth, mass into gravity into height. So, 30, that the given value, 30 into 10, that is acceleration due to gravity 10 meter per second square, and height is 1.5 meter. When you multiply this, 30 into 10, 300 into 1.5. So, when you multiply this, you'll be getting answer as 450 joule. And lastly, they have asked to find, this is a sub question. This is a sub question, what we have discussed now. And the B question is, account for the differences in answers to parts 1 and 2. So we should know the difference of the sub question, that is from A, that is first and second. So what is the difference here? What is the difference between the work done and the potential energy? Out of the work done 600 joules, only 450 joules of energy is utilized, and the remaining energy is considered as the base energy or the force of friction in order to move the slope from A to B. Our full energy will not be used in any form of energy. Few of energy is wasted. Or the we call this the dissipation of energy or the degraded energy. While using due to friction force, some energy will be wasted. So initially, 6 out of 600 joules, we should apply 600 joules of work should be done in order to move the block from A to B, but only 450 joules as energy was there, the potential energy, and the remaining 150 energy of the block is spent against the force of friction between the two blocks and the slope, which is converted into heat energy. That is the difference.
Yeah.
energy. So the energy converted into electrical energy that is equals to only 60% water. Energy available from the falling water, that is initial potential energy. Initial potential energy is the stored energy. Next, energy converted into electrical energy, that is only 60% of gained energy from the falling water. So which they are asked to find out the power generated. So we know that this percentage can be converted into fraction. So 60%, 60 divided by 100 into gained energy from the falling water. So that is nothing but the potential energy. The gained energy from the falling water, that is potential energy 100 liter. Once again we have considered here. So 10 get cancelled here. And again these two zeros can be written as 10 power of 2 and this one as the 10 power of 3. So finally what we should multiply here? 6 into 9.8 into 10 power of 3. 10 and 2 zeros. Add the powers. So what will be getting? 9, not 100 and 10.